he said that what difference does it make what we call it? Well, what if you went to a doctor's clinic with a serious illness, you had tuberculosis, and the doctor says, I'm going to call what you have the flu or a common cold. Here's a couple of aspirins, go home.
What if in World War II we didn't identify Nazism for what it is, or Imperial Japan for the enemy that they are?
Or
Reagan say it, an evil empire.
Right, this is when you have to bring Americans together. Those people weren't gay people, they were Americans.
By the way, under Sharia, radical Islamists, if it was a group of women dancing, they would feel justified in doing this.
Listening to music. The Taliban banned music in Afghanistan.
All right, I'm trying to understand. It's pathological at this point to me, the president, Hillary Clinton, and the Democrats.
It is.
It's inexplicable. It's, you know, I don't understand this mysterious reluctance and resistance to identify an enemy. I want to play some things for you. Let's first go to the New York Times, Nicholas Kristof, and they talked about Obama when he was in a Muslim school. He said he recalled, in a first-rate accent, by the way, the opening lines of the Arabic call to prayer, reciting them with a first-rate accent in a remark that seemed delightfully uncalculated, and it'll give Alabama voters a heart attack. But Mr. Obama described the call to Muslim prayer as one of the prettiest sounds on earth at sunset. Now, I'm going to play for you back to back his comments about Islam and his comments about Christianity, and I want you to respond. Let's roll the tape.
The United States is not and will never be at war with Islam. And I'm also proud to carry with me the goodwill of the American people and a greeting of peace for Muslim communities in my country. Assalamu alaikum. Islam is not part of the problem in combating violent extremism. It is an important part of promoting peace. Our enemies respect no religious freedom. Al-Qaeda's cause is not Islam. It's a gross distortion of Islam. The future must not belong to those who slander the Prophet of Islam. ISIL is not Islamic. No religion condones the killing of innocents, and the vast majority of ISIL's victims have been Muslim. We have reaffirmed again and again that the United States is not and never will be at war with Islam. Islam teaches peace. Remember that during the Crusades and the Inquisition, people committed terrible deeds in the name of Christ. Slavery, Jim Crow, all too often was justified in the name of Christ. On Easter, I do reflect on the fact that as a Christian, I am supposed to love. And I have to say that sometimes when I listen to less than loving expressions by Christians, I get concerned.
He won't say radical Islam. You heard his comments about Islam. Terrible deeds in the name of Christ.
Horrific. Well, what nation are we? Who were the founding fathers? What creator are they referring to in our founding documents? Are they referring to Allah or some nameless blob? No, they're referring to the God of the New Testament.
Judeo-Christian values.
Absolutely. Why is the sympathy always for the other? Why is America the problem, Sean?
Now, let's add to this. An Iranian deal where you give the number one state sponsor of terror $150 billion. Let's add to that American bloodshed for Ramadi and Mosul and Fallujah and to Crete. Let's add to that Mohamed Morsi, former head of the Muslim Brotherhood, a terrorist organization, becomes the head of the president of Egypt. And he gives him tanks, F-16s, and $1 billion+. A guy that referred to the Israelis as descendants of apes and pigs. He is on the wrong side all of the time.
And when a man comes along who's a Muslim who says, I'm not letting the Brotherhood steal my country, I've met President Sisi, what do? We reject him.
President El-Sisi has had more courage to stand up to radicalism than the president of the United States.
He's on the front line.
But here's my question. Why? What is it?
Look, let's leave conspiracy theories to the side.
Not conspiracy. It's inexplicable
to me.
It's
one thing. I'll give you the explanation. This man comes from a certain ideological background, okay? His buddy was Bill Ayers. He grew up with a certain individual.
Bernadine Dorn,
right.
Reverend Wright,
right.
A.
Marshall,
Alinsky,
right.
Frank Marshall Davis.
So what's the common denominator? America is the problem. Whatever the issue is, we are the problem. And as a result, he's always going to sympathize with who? the bad guys. This idea now that this guy had a twisted sexual identity in Orlando, he was suffering, we're going to make the perpetrator out to be the victim eventually. It's unconscionable, Sean.
I don't think anybody else in the media will put that together what we just did.
No, and I'm glad you did it. That's powerful.
Sebastian, good to see you. Thank you.
Thank you, Sean.